VINCI, a world leader in concessions and construction, recently reported first-half results. What does the rest of the year look like for VINCI? Let's find out. Xavier Huillard, welcome.
Hello, Adrian.
You're the chairman and CEO of VINCI. We're getting to the end of the third quarter of 2013. How's the year going for VINCI?
So far, 2013 has been a year of challenges in a difficult economic climate. But overall, we did slightly better than expected. Our revenue and EBITDA increased over the first half, and there was a slight contraction in our operating income and net income. In France, business benefited from the ramp-up of the Tours-Bordeaux high-speed rail line project. Outside France, revenue growth was driven by acquisition activity, which is in line with the strategy we adopted several years ago. Our half-year operating income was affected by the harsh weather, which penalized our roadworks business in France and also outside France. In addition, we had to provision costs incurred in Poland to deal with a strong decline in the road business in that country. Lastly, there were negative accounting impacts on income resulting from an increase in amortization expense and financing costs following the opening of the Balbigny-Lyon section of the A89 motorway and the commissioning of the widened section of the A63.